This is a Walt Disney original little long-playing record, and I am your Disneyland story reader. I am going to begin now to read the story of Hansel and Gretel. You can read along with me in your book. You will know it is time to turn the page when Tinkerbell rings her little bells like this. Let's begin now. Once upon a time, in a small cottage on the edge of a great forest, there lived a poor woodcutter and his family. The son was named Hansel. His younger sister was named Gretel. The woodcutter's wife was their stepmother. She was a very mean and selfish woman. One evening there was so little food left, it seemed they all must starve. The stepmother told the woodcutter that she had an evil plan to take Hansel and Gretel into the forest and leave them to starve. "Get rid of the children," she told him. "Then there will be enough food for you and for me." The wicked stepmother persisted. Finally, the poor woodcutter agreed. Hansel and Gretel heard the plan and they were frightened. Hansel whispered to Gretel that he had a plan of his own. When it was dark, he went quietly outside the cottage and filled his pockets with tiny white stones. The next day, off to the woods they all went. Hansel dropped a few stones every few steps. When they reached a place deep in the forest, the stepmother and their father left them to sleep by a fire, telling them they would soon return. But they didn't come back. That night, when the moon rose, Hansel took Gretel by her hand, and following the tiny moonlit stones, they found their way back to the cottage. The stepmother was furious. The next morning, they all went to the woods again. Hansel had no time to pick up small stones, but he had saved a crust of bread, so he dropped crumbs all along the way to make a trail he could follow out of the forest. The woodcutter and his wife again left the children. When darkness came, Hansel took Gretel by the hand. They looked and looked for a trail of breadcrumbs, but birds had eaten all the crumbs. Now they were indeed lost and alone. They wandered through the forest for 3 long days, sleeping cuddled up under trees at night. Then on the 4th day, they came upon a very welcome sight. It was a tiny cottage, and it was made of bread. The roof was made of cake, and the windows were sugar candy. Hansel and Gretel each ate and ate pieces of the cottage. Suddenly, a voice came from within.
"Nibbling, nibbling like a mouse? Who's nibbling at my house?"
Then, out the cottage door came a little old woman.
"Fear not, children," said the old woman. "Come in and dine and rest."
Hansel and Gretel were very glad to do so. As soon as the sun rose the next morning, the old lady woke them. She invited them out to see the stable. And before they knew what was happening, she threw Hansel inside and bolted the stable door.
"Ha-ha!" she cried. "I'm really a witch, and I eat children. And I'll eat you first, young man, when you have been fattened a bit." "You, young lady," she said to Gretel, "will carry food and water to your brother until he's plump enough to make me a tasty meal."
Gretel was very frightened, especially a few days later when the old witch heated the oven to cook her and her dear brother.
"Taste it, dearie," said the witch. "I'm going to bake some bread. Put your head inside and see if the oven is warm enough."
But Gretel was too smart for that.
"My head won't fit that little space," she said. "Oh, yes, it will," answered the witch. "Look, it's even big enough for me."
And she put her own head in. Suddenly, Gretel gave the witch a big push, and into the oven she went. Gretel slammed the oven door shut and ran to rescue her brother from the stable. Hansel and Gretel left the old witch in the oven to cook, and then they found diamonds and emeralds and pearls under the beds. They filled their pockets and ran away as fast as they could. Soon they came to a place in the forest that looked familiar. Then they saw their own cottage. They rushed in and greeted their father. He was very glad to see them alive. Their stepmother had died since the children left. Now, with the riches from the diamonds, the emeralds and the pearls, they could all live happily. And they did, forever after.
Me, both my hands I offer thee, right foot first, left foot then, on the vault and back again. I would dance, but don't know how, when to jump or when to bow. Show me what I ought to do, so that I may dance like you. With your foot you tap, 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 with your hand you clap, 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 right foot first, left foot then, again. With your foot you tap, 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 with your hand you clap, 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 right foot first, left foot then, round and back again. That was very good indeed. Oh, I'm sure you'll soon succeed. Try again and I can see Hansel soon will dance like me. With your head you nick, 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 with your fingers you click, 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 right foot first, left foot then, on the vault and back again. With your head you nick, 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 with your fingers you click, 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 right foot first, left foot then, round and back again. She will.